the deep man for the Packers, waiting for the punt back here at the 30. And the Packers will have their first opportunity in good field position at the Minuteman 38-yard line. First and 10, Desert Christian Academy. We encourage everyone to visit the Spirit Store located at the west end of the bleachers. Get all your Calgary regalia, hats and shirts and other things that you must have. The holidays are approaching with picnic group stocking stuffers. Good to be home. First and 10, Desert Christian Academy from the Minuteman 27-yard line. Jacob Reynolds around the left side. Pickup of about 5 will bring up 2nd and 5 for Desert Christian. Jacob Reynolds, ball carrier again on the right side. Loss of a couple will bring up 2nd down and 8. For Desert Christian. But be sure to support Desert Christian Academy Athletics by visiting the Concord Cafe. We have nachos, full pork nachos, full pork sandwiches, full pork fried candles, and other things to impress you. Runs on the end of the ball carrier. Takes it out to about the 25-yard line. Where it will be 4th and 7. Tyler Rogers passes complete to Jacob Reynolds. No blunt gain on the play, and Maranatha will take over on downs.
Blue! White! Get that ball! Blue! White! Get that ball!
Julian Greca on the snap for the Packers, number 21. Miguel Vasquez on the quarterback keeper in Vermont. Three, they bring up second down and seven from the Maranatha 28-yard line. Vasquez's pass is complete to Connor Patterson for a touchdown, 72 yards on the play. Owen Meeks on to attempt the PAT. And it's good. There was 7:24 left in the first quarter. It's Maranatha 7. The Packers are ready to receive the kickoff. Matt Garrison, please report to the clock and scores table, please. Matt Garrison. First and 10, Desert Christian Academy from their own 28-yard line. Dakota Young picks up the middle to just across the 30. Game of 7 on the play. 8 will bring up second down and 2. For your Packers. Jacob Reynolds tries that left side. Okay, here we go. And that's enough for another Packer. First and 10, Desert Christian Academy. From the 34-yard line. Thank you. Rogers, the ball carrier. Gets it out to the 39-yard line. Gain of 5 on the play. We'll bring up 2nd down and 5 for DCA. Rogers' pass is incomplete. Jaden Herman, the intended receiver, will bring up 3rd and 5 for DCA. Many of you guys may be under the impression that I returned tonight just to call the football game, but the reality is I'm here to collect some late homework. Some of you guys still got Army DBQs from 2019. Rogers' pass is complete to Dayton Ring. And a two on the play to bring up 4th and 3. From the 41-yard line. Elijah Mulaney and Cannon Espinoza in on the tackle. It'll be Maranatha's ball. Just shy of the 50-yard line. 1st and 10 from their own 49. Vasquez on the quarterback keeper rambles 51 yards for the Minutemen touchdown. Owen Malekas, point after is good, and Maranatha extends their lead to 14-0. Julia Greca and Jaden Hurlin back deep for the Conquerors to receive the kick. Malacca to kick it off. Hurling, Jaden Hurling with a nice return, takes it out to about the 38-yard line where the Conquerors will have it, first and 10. Elijah Maloney ran out of bounds at about the 46-yard line. Gain of 7 will bring up second down and 3 for your Desert Christian Academy Conquerors. Jacob Reynolds with a nice second effort gets it out to midfield. And that's enough for another Conqueror. First and 10, Desert Christian Academy from the 50-yard line. Cannon Espinoza, loss of one in the play, will bring up second down and 11. They'll have plenty of time to take care of your appetite at the Conqueror Cafe. There's butter cake cookies and other treats for sale that Johanna Klein. Elijah Maloney, the block carrier, lost a run. We're going to have 3rd and 12 for the Conquerors. Stop by and purchase butter cake cookies and other treats from Johanna Klein under the Market Light Lighting. Snow cones are also for sale under the Market Lighting. For the Conquerors. Tyler Rogers punt goes out of bounds at about the 15-yard line. 40 yards on the punt, no return. It'll be first and 10 men. Cody Young on the stop for the Conquerors. Miles O'Malley, the ball carrier. Dylan Smith and Dakota Young on the stop. 6 yards on the play. Second down and four. Miles O'Malley with a nice gain for the Minutemen down to the Conqueror 40-yard line. First and 10, Maranatha. Vasquez's pass is complete to Connor Patterson. Gaten Hurling on the stop for the Conquerors. And that's the end of the first quarter. The Maranatha Panthers ball to begin the second quarter. First and 10 from the Panthers 14-yard line. Vasquez's pass is complete to Jamal Reeves, 14 yards for the touchdown. Aaron Malachi in the attempt at the PAT. And it's good. Now would be a good time to meet that DCA cheer squad. A freshman.
Hello.
Ms. Lynn Meyer. Jen Myers. A freshman. Brindley Woolley. A sophomore. Brooke Billhartz, a sophomore, Bailey Rogers, a sophomore, Lizzie Gregory, a sophomore, Katie Hertel, and the cheer squad is coached by Mrs. Lisa Rogers. First and 10, Desert Christian Academy. First and 10 from the 46-yard line. Falls on the errant snap. Loss of one in the play. Second down and 11 from the 45. Andrew Husser split wide for the Panthers on the far side. Dakota Young fights his way to midfield, just shy of midfield. They'll bring up third down and 6 for Desert Christian. Jacob Reynolds, gain of about 6 or 7 on the play. There is a fumble that the Minutemen recover. The Minutemen will have a first and 10 from the Conqueror 43-yard line. Ashton Scott. Cannon Espinoza and Julian Greco on the tackle. First and 10. Minutemen from their own 40-yard line. Miles O'Malley down to about the 5-yard line will be first and goal for Maffa. Takes it in from 5 yards. Touchdown, Maranatha. Goes kick, splits the uprights, and Maranatha extends their lead to 28-0. Flag on the play, the kick sails out of bounds. Espinoza takes it off the midfield, 15 yards, and that's enough for another Conqueror.
First down!
First and 10 doesn't push the Cannon after the run by Cannon Espinoza. For Cannon, you could say that was a high caliber run. Well, you guys knew exactly what type of humor to expect tonight. Yeah.
for another 15-yard run down to about the 45. And that's enough for another Conqueror
touchdown!
Houston Penn Desert Christian Academy from the Maranatha 35. Picks up another 5 yards. He's second down and 5 from the 30-yard line. Procedure against the Conquerors. They'll take it back to loss of 5 on the penalty. They'll to take it down. Second down and 10. Back up to 35 from the original line of scrimmage. Packers recover the ball back at the 41. Loss of 6 in the play will bring up 3rd down and 16. Cannon picks up about 3 in the play. We'll bring up 4th and 13 for the Conquerors from the Maranatha 37-38 yard line. Movement prior to the snap. We'll see who it's on. The coach went against Maranatha. Takes it to the 33-yard line. Will be 4th down and 7. Rogers pass intended for Husser, incomplete, and Maranatha will take over on downs. Being a four on the play, and now the back area to second down and six. Vasquez's pass is complete off of the 45-yard line. Julian Greco on the tackle, bring up first and 10 for the main man from their own 45-yard line. Transfer recovered by Maranatha. Also, three of the players bring up second down and 13. Harrison on the reception. Devin Castellano on the tackle.
Hey, go!
along with Levine Dashkowski.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you are part of the homecoming court, please make your way to Halsey Field. Homecoming court, Halsey Field, please. Thank you very much.
First and goal, Maranatha from inside the five. Devin Castellanos with the stop. Brings up second and goal. So if you want any DCA regalia, sweatshirts, hats, t-shirts, knickknacks, this student store, the state store, will be open until the end of halftime. At the end of halftime, the student store closes, so get in line as soon as the crowning of our new king and queen is over, so don't miss your chance. Julian Greca on the return up to the 37-yard line, where the Conquerors will take over first and 10. Yeah. throw, but Aguero with the interception takes it down to about the 11-yard line. Will be first and 10 for the men. Delay a game against Maranatha. Still first down, first and 15 from the 6th line. Second down and 17 with just 5 seconds left in the half. We have a timeout running out and we're lining up for a, it looks like a 33-yard field goal. Julian Groka with the block field goal cover at halftime with Maranatha ahead 35-0. Be sure to stay in your seats as we crown our royalty for the 2022-23 school year.
Good evening, students, parents, alumni, families, and friends. Welcome, and thank you so much for joining us for our homecoming celebration. Please direct your attention to the field and enjoy our halftime ceremony. First, give it up for our varsity cheerleaders. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating freshman princess, Alani Diaz, and Prince Brock Adams. Sophomore class, Princess Madison Reedman, and Prince Judah Engel. Representing our junior class, Princess Jolene Major and Prince Dusty Nixon. And now, please give a round of applause for our senior court. Prince Knight Williams. Describes himself as a reliable driven and logical. His favorite DCA memory was the Grand Canyon trip last year because it was fun to get away from all the craziness here at school and go hike for 6 hours straight. Knight is inspired most by his parents because they know what it takes to accomplish what he wants to accomplish and how to do it. When asked who or what has helped him grow spiritually, Knight said that Mrs. Garrison has helped him by challenging what he believes and giving him answers to the big questions that he has. In 10 years, he sees himself somewhere on the coast of California with a job that he loves. Prince Knight Williams. Princess Kate Williams, accompanied by her father, Mr. Joe Williams. Kate plays Kate plays volleyball, soccer, and softball for DCA. She's inspired most by her mom because she is so loving and caring to everyone she meets, and she always goes out of her way to serve others first. Kate's favorite verse is Psalm 56:13. For you have delivered me from death and my feet from stumbling, that I may walk before God in the light of life. She likes this verse because it reminds her that no matter what happens in life, she has been given the greatest gift ever and is free to live a life that glorifies God. She says Mr. Fulton has helped her grow spiritually by always providing a safe space to ask any question and constantly encouraging her to think deeper about her faith. In 10 years, she sees herself surrounded by people she loves and definitely with a dog or two. Kate's advice to current students is to remember to tell people how much you appreciate and care for them. Princess Kate Williams. Prince Jaden Myers. Jaden plays football and baseball, and his favorite memory was whitewater rafting and kayaking on the senior trip. He is inspired most by his dad and the hard work he does for the family and how his dad serves others every day through his job in law enforcement. His favorite Bible verse is Psalm 23:4. Even when I walk through the darkest valley, I will not be afraid, for you are close beside me. Your rod and your staff protect and comfort me. This verse encourages Jaden to always lean on God in times of hardship. In 10 years, Jaden sees himself in a career he enjoys and with a family. Jaden's advice for students on campus is to enjoy every single moment of high school and to get involved in sports and other activities. Prince Jaden Meyer. Princess Natalie Duncan, accompanied by her father, Mr. Keith Duncan. Natalie plays volleyball and basketball and is pursuing basketball in college. She is inspired most by her parents because they are so hardworking and have taught her that if you are going to do something, you should do it to your fullest ability. Natalie's favorite Bible verse is Proverbs 31:25. She is clothed with strength and dignity, and she laughs without fear of the future. Because this verse reminds her to not stress about future things outside of her control. Her favorite memory was going down a Class 3 rapid backwards on the senior trip. Natalie's advice for students on campus is to have a good attitude, because you can spoil the most amazing moments in life with a bad attitude. Having fun and cherishing memories comes with being willing to be positive. Princess Natalie Duncan. Next up, Prince Julian Greco. Julian plays football and describes himself as ambitious, easygoing, and independent. His favorite DCA memory was the senior trip. Julian is inspired most by his dad because he moved to California by himself when he was 17 and had no plan and eventually started his own business. He has also been inspired by a couple of coaches and mentors. His favorite verse is Matthew 19 through 21, because the issue of worshiping materialistic things is so present in our society nowadays, and this verse is a reminder of our true purpose of living. 10 years, Julian hopes to be financially stable, living in Southern California, and working in a career that he enjoys. Julian Greco. Next up, Princess Kate Smith, accompanied by her father and alumni, David Smith. Kate plays volleyball and is involved in ASB and describes herself as adventurous, determined, and joyful. She is inspired most by her parents because they have always supported her and encouraged her to seek the Lord in all things. They have poured so much into her and her siblings,
and she admires the way that they live their lives. Kate's favorite Bible verse is Philippians 4:8-9, because it's a reminder that when we fix our thoughts on things that are honorable to God, we experience His peace. Kate wants to live her life for Christ and believes it all starts with her thought life. In 10 years, Kate sees herself with a family and working in ministry. Her advice to current students is to make the best out of every situation and take your relationship with God seriously. Princess Kate Smith. Prince Everett Ridenour. Everett plays soccer and he describes himself as optimistic, charismatic, and authentic. He's inspired most by his uncle, who has a strong relationship with God and works hard every day to provide for his aunt and cousins. Everett aspires to be like him one day. His favorite memory was hiking the Grand Canyon in a pair of Converse. His feet had so many blisters and were so sore, but he said it was worth it when he reached the plateau. When asked who or what helped him grow spiritually, Everett shared that the last night of the Grand Canyon trip helped him put more faith into God and shifted his perspective more to the Lord than on himself. His advice to current students is to take risks and not be fearful, because only the fearless can be great. Prince Everett Ridenour. Princess Julissa Flores, accompanied by her father, Mr. Alejandro Flores. Julissa plays soccer and softball, and her parents inspire her the most because they push her to be a better version of herself every day. Julissa's favorite Bible verse is Romans 8:18. Yet what we suffer now is nothing compared to the glory He will reveal to us later. She loves this verse because it reminds us of our future in God's glory, regardless of the sufferings we go through here on earth. Julissa's favorite memory was last year when her house won the Spirit Week Cup. In 10 years, she sees herself opening up her own clothing shop and an iced white chocolate mocha from Starbucks in her hand. Her advice to current students is to make as many memories as you can. Princess Julissa Flores. Seniors, thank you so much for being incredible leaders on our campus and for being here tonight representing your senior class. And now, let's crown DCA's homecoming king. Aaron Kloppenstein, Latvia's homecoming king, will come and crown the king and put the sash on. So ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating this year's 2022 homecoming king, Mr. Jaden Meyer. Congratulating this year's 2022 homecoming queen, Miss Kate Smith. for the first time, our 2022 homecoming king and queen, everybody. Congratulations to our entire 2022 homecoming court, and thank you for joining us for this halftime celebration. Everybody stick around for pictures over here. Hang on. Students, what am I forgetting? That's right, everybody, it's Spirit Week, right? All right, I've got some results for you students. Are you ready for this? All right, listen up. Here we go. While they're getting pictures, let's celebrate Spirit Week Cup. All right, this is just for the dance. And then I'll give final results. Are you ready? I like to drag it all out. All right. So first place gets 400 points. Second place, 300. Third place gets 200. And fourth place gets 100. Here's the results. In fourth place, Epimelis. In third place, Stop the Roast. Second place. No, we won't go second place. Let's just go first place with Archibald! That's right, second place is Fuchsia! Now. That's just dance competition. All I gotta say is yes. Here we go, listen. Here's what's crazy. Archimedes started at the bottom and won. They won the dance. That's a lot of points, everybody. So the overall standings for 2022 Spirit Cup this year in fourth place, Epimelis. With 739 points. Third place, Stathoros. 876 points. And this year's Spirit Cup goes to none other than Dixia! With 1,032 points. And Archimos also close with 1,005 points. So close. Hey, great job everybody this week. Give it up once again for your homecoming court.
at kickoff. 1 minute.
Thank you.
Jaden Hurling with a nice return on the kickoff. And then there was a fumble being covered. Lost it to the play, brings up second and 12 for the Conquerors. Personal foul against the defense. Takes the ball across midfield to the Maranatha 46-yard line. And that's enough for another Packer. First and 10 Desert Christian Academy from the Maranatha 46-yard line. Jacob Reynolds, the ball carrier. Gaining about three on the play. Fumbles. The ball is loose, as we see who is recovered by. Balls recovered by the Menopin. The first and 10 Maranatha from their own 41-yard line. Patterson takes it to the distance for a touchdown. After attempt is good. Yeah. Jaden Hurling on the return. And now not the territory. He's brought down at about the 43-yard line. First and 10 Contours. They bring up second and 10. Gain of 8 on the play will bring up 3rd down and 2. 3rd down and 2. Dakota Young steamrolls himself out to about the 21 minute. 3 on the play will be a second down and 6. 24 on the play. Thank you.
there.
Timeout, Maranatha. Crashes money on the corner after kick. O'Malley on the return. Takes it out to the 15 yard line. First and 10. Mountain. Vadim and Jeremiah Reynolds on the tackle. You could say that was on Reynolds' lap. Another flag on the far side of the field. Whoa! the officials to take this one out. So, we have three dead ball and sportsmanlike conduct against Maranatha. The ball goes back to, first be the 3-yard line. It'll be first and goal Minutemen from the 3-yard line. I'm sorry, first and 10 for the Minutemen from their own 3-yard line. Michael Martin, the ball carrier, picks up 22 to first and 10, Minutemen to the 25. Devin Castellanos with the tackle for the loss. Loss of about 3 on the play. We'll bring up second down and 13 for Maranatha.
Hey,
Fourth and short for the Minutemen. Incomplete pass, and the Packers will take over on downs from the Maranatha 36-yard line. Espinoza. Inside the 30, it'll be second down and 3 for the Conquerors. Jacob Reynolds, down to the 21-yard line. And that's enough for another Conqueror. First and 10, Desert Christian Academy. From the Maranatha 21-yard line. His way forward for a gain of 3 to bring up second down and 7. Launches forward for 4 yards, a third down and 2. Movement on the play against the Conquerors, be 5-yard penalty for offside or motion. False start. Third down and 7. Thank you. Espinoza is a blast forward. Inside the 10, back to 6. And that's enough for another Packer. Cannon runs the ball. Gain of 2 on the play to bring up 2nd and goal. We have an injured player on the field. Sides against the defense. Half the distance to the goal line. 2nd and goal. Time out, Desert Christian Academy. We'd like to welcome our alumni tonight to homecoming. Our most senior alumni tonight is from way, way back, the class of 1985, John Quintero. Mr. Quintero graduated in June, and I started teaching here in August. I missed him by 2 months. From the class of 1987, we have everyone's favorite pastor, Larry Gatlin. Spinoza brought down for a short loss in the play, bringing up third and goal. From the class of 1991, everyone's favorite chef, Kerry Santanos Kemp. Christian Academy. From the class of 1996, we would like to welcome back Mr. Nick, Dr. Nick Nixon, Betsy Young, and Krista Young. From the class of 1998, the proud parents of our homecoming queen, Daniel Smith and Megan Stein. The 2-point conversion attempt is no good. From the class of 1999, welcome back Matthew Bradtrue. There is an injured player on the field. From the class of 2000, we have Mr. Tom Fulton and Leah Dye. Class of 2001, welcome back, Blake Stein. From the class of 2002, Richard Mangus. From the class of 2003, Miss Laura Young. From class of 04, the kicker, Cameron Paradise. From the class of 2005, Michelle Young. From the class of 2006, Heather Spellenberg. From the class of 2007, we have Joseph Stein and Mary Young. From the class of 2008, my former teacher aide, Morgan McCoy. Josiah Garrison on the stop for the Conkers. From the class of 2013, we have Gary. From the class of 2020, we have Carissa Bolton, Paul Passon, Isabella Correa, Gloria Juarez, and Nathan Young. From the class of 2018, Micah Myers. From the class of 2017, our newly minted 2018, our newly minted girls varsity basketball coach, Zach of Three Devane. From the class of 2021, Soraya Angle, Courtney Collin, and Cameron Ridenhour. Please keep it back. And from the class of 2022, we have Tony Goble, Annika Mays, Cammie Nixon. Jeremy Reynolds and Gwen Roward. Brooke Hesser. From the class of 2020, we have Aiden Scott, Jared Butzloff, and Zachary Garcia. And I'm sure there was a bevy of women we missed who came in a different gate. But welcome home, everybody. Castellano and Anita. And Chase Collins all in the stop. Caden Egerbrotten on the stop. First and 10 Minutemen from the 24-yard line. Caden Egerbrotten on the stop. Thank you. Tyler Reedman leads a covey of Conquerors on the stop. Delay a game against the Minutemen. Loss of five in the play. We're going to third and goal from about the 9-yard line.